Hey everybody, I'm Ivan. In this video, I will make and install an AC heated bed on my printer. At the end of the installation, the main benefits should be much faster time to reach the hotbed temperature and also enlarged range of temperatures going up to 130 degrees. Today with my PC heated bed, I can go up to 100 degrees for maybe 15 minutes. The last benefit is that there will be more power from your PCU remaining for motors, lighting, the control board and any other peripherals you may have on your printer. It means also that if you are building a 3D printer from scratch, you can use much smaller PCU because the main power consumer in a printer is the hotbed. Now, it's a great upgrade, but it comes with some serious safety concerns. And here is time for my disclaimer. To build my AC heated bed, I will use a 5mm thick casted and stress-relieved milled aluminium plate. It was machined for my printer and has the size of the stock hotbed. Then I bought a 750W silicone heater from Keenovo. It covers completely the aluminium plate. You may want to use a thermal fuse for safety. Myself, I won't be using the fuse, but I will have two SSR relays to control the bed temperature instead of just one. I will explain later on why. Instead of springs, I will have high temperature silicone spacers between the bed and the supporting plate. For all power connections, I will use silicone cable with cross-section of 1.5 square millimeters. The first step of the installation is to stick the silicone heater. I cleaned the plate with isopropyl alcohol to assure better adhesion. Applying the heater is easy. First, I had to align the edges on one side and then to slowly peel off the sticker while chasing the air bubbles. Here you see how to mount the silicone spacers. Now there is something I personally find not well taught. The power and thermistor wires are centered, and this is the position where is installed the Y-axis motor. On the stock bed, there on the right. Here, however, I decided to move them on the left side in order to have bigger clearances. My printer is ready to support the heavier weight of this bed. It will be running on two linear rails with two carriages each. I use also a 9mm Gates belt and a large, more powerful stepper motor for the Y-axis. I moved the stepper to the left as much as I could in order to have more space for the heater wires. Here you see how I have passed the cables. As a strain relief, I use the same accessory I had with the stock bed. Mounting the bed afterwards is pretty straightforward. The standard diagram uses thermal fuse attached to the hotbed that protects the printer if the SSR fails in closed position. I don't want to drill my plate to attach a fuse, and I will use instead a second SSR connected in series. This should reduce dramatically the probability of failure in closed position. If the first SSR fails, the second will continue to operate the hotbed. My final diagram is this one. One SSR cuts the neutral and the second cuts the line. I did it this way because in my country you can plug in the socket both ways and you never know where is the line. This avoids the line to go to the printer when not printing. Now I have additional level of security through Octoprint and its enclosure plugin. Even if the two SSR fail in open position, which is not probable, the print will fail because of an error for abnormal temperature of the heated bed. If the print fails, the enclosure plugin will shut down everything through this electromechanical contactor. So with all these extra precautions and improved relay logic, I believe this system is safe enough even without using a thermal fuse. So what do you think? Do I miss a layer of safety here? Please drop a comment below. The connection from the control board is simple. I disconnected the wires from the hotbed MOSFET. Then I pulled two wires from the control board hotbed connector. These wires will control the on and off states of the SSRs. On the top of the PCU are taped some holes for M4 screws. I will use them to fix the two solid state relays. Here you can see how I made the connections. The control wires are connected in parallel to the control terminals of the relays. The power terminals will connect to the neutral and to the line of the power supply through the black and the red wires. If you have any questions, please drop a comment below. Now, all I have to do is connect the power wires from the relays with the power wires of the silicone heater, as well the wires for the thermistor. As an additional safety measure, I made an earthing connection for the frame at the Y-axis linear rails. So, this is the skeleton of a new printer I'm building, the Volum switch wire. It has a lot of 3D printed parts, and I will test my new heated bed by printing those parts. I think it will be something like 5 or 6 days of continuous printing. So, let's see how it goes. So now I'm printing with the new heated bed for 2 hours and a half already. I am printing ABS. So first layer was at 110, then the temperature is 105 of the heated bed. It keeps it steady. And what's interesting is this, the temperature inside enclosure. I haven't switched on the enclosure heater, and I see that the temperature in the enclosure just with the heated bed reaches 40.5 degrees Celsius, which is very fine for ABS. With the previous bed, the temperature could go around 31-32 degrees Celsius. That's why I had to install a heater. The ABS prints at slow speed of 50 millimeters per second, and at this speed the quality seems fine.
Here you see how I fixed the cable for the heat bed and the strain relief in action. I have printed many ABS parts, but also some parts from polycarbonate at 120 degrees Celsius bed temperature and 60 degrees chamber. The bed performed really well in keeping the temperature steady for long print hours. Here are all the parts printed during the test.
So, by the time I managed to assemble this video, my new printer is already operational and I will present it maybe in a separate video. This is very fast Core XZ printer that goes with speeds up to 150 mm per second and acceleration of up to 2000. In conclusion, for the AC heated bed, I can say that it was a great upgrade. I think it's better suited for Core XY machines because this additional mass of the bed and the inertia is minimized. But it's okay on Cartesian as well. For speeds up to 80 mm per second, it's what I tested. This bed reaches 110 degrees in less than 3 minutes and it can go up to 130 degrees in long run. This allows you to print more filaments and also to print them on a regular PEI sheet. And it also contributes to the temperature in the enclosure if you have one. So printing ABS is very easy. I didn't have a single failed ABS print since I have it. And I don't have to use my enclosure heater. The heated bed is enough to maintain the temperature steady around 40 degrees Celsius. I saw some people using the stock heat bed with powerful silicone heaters. Here the aluminum plate is just 2 or 2.5 millimeters thick. Well, don't do it. Those beds are rated for normally up to 100 degrees slow heating and you don't know how will they behave when you heat them fast. Probably bent. So for me it's not a reliable solution to use the stock bed with a silicone heater this powerful. They have also much less mass and this will lead to even faster heating up, cooling down cycles, which will in turn increase the switching operations of the solid state relay, and I think it will lead to a shorter life of the hotbed. Myself, I had some safety concerns installing such powerful component on a moving bed, but okay, it has already a few hundred printing hours without any issues, and I believe what is most important to keep it safe is to wire it well. So the strain relief is very important. And then to add some additional layer of safety, either through a thermal fuse or like I did with additional relay logic. So there are links to the products in this video in the description. Thank you for watching and see you for my next project. Bye bye.